We were not prepared for Walvis Bay. And that's where the problem came. In many ways, in the sense that we did not form a coordinated response. It was a fight between politics, and then you have the business community left out, you have the private doctor, you have community members who are not part of the response.
According to Haufiku, one of the main reasons for the spike in positive COVID-19 cases in Walvis Bay can be attributed to overcrowding, as the people in informal settlements such as Tualoloka and others do not have access to decent housing and sanitation.
Up until last week, we had more than 1,000 people who were tested positive for COVID-19, but at home in their apartments, not in isolation. Now, how do you control the pandemic when you test so many people but not isolating them? And you have people in Walvis Bay, in Patient Moon, who share a bathroom and a shower, up to 30 of them, yes, in the backyard. Go to Tararoka and see what's happening. Again, the root cause we know is the social issue of housing. People don't have proper housing. And I'm not saying that for political things. I'm just saying this as a hard reality and for public interest, that we lost the battle in Walvis Bay because of poor coordination and ill preparation. And now we say, is the virus circulating in Windhoek's world? My answer is probably yes. Most likely, I must not say probably. Most likely. It's just that we have been behind in testing. Because of the backlog, you're actually not reporting the patients that are tested in the last 24 hours. You're reporting on patients that are tested 7 days ago. And you don't know what the next 7 days will look like. At the beginning, I requested that Oshakati, Walvis Bay, Oswako, Katima, Kietman must have testing machine. I was told I'm imposing my will on the will of other people. The collective decision was that the machine in Windhoek is suffice when we had 60 cases. I said, look, we can put those machines there. If we don't pick up many cases that need to be tested, we can bring back the machines. Instead of not putting the machine there and in a panicky mode, we go and shuffle here and complain about that. So we have to take the blame, especially those of us who were in the response, and especially leadership, including myself, that we were not prepared in Walvis Bay. That's why we have what we have in Walvis Bay. And it would be the same if we are not prepared in Oshakati, in Windhoek, in all other places. Because it's a matter of you being ahead of the virus. Once you allow the virus to be ahead of you, that's it. Takes the lead.
The Irongo region has recorded the highest COVID-19 positive cases as well as deaths related to the virus in Namibia. Haufiku said that it is time for the government to consider changing its strategy on testing, isolation and treatment of COVID-19 patients and those who are at risk of contracting the virus in Walvis Bay.
Our focus now must be to, one, to test everyone at risk, not just everyone in the community. Health workers, because you know health workers are increasingly getting infected. If I pick it up in your hotel, the whole hotel must be tested, etc. That must be continuing. But more importantly, we must now protect the most vulnerable. Anyone over the age of 65, any hypertensive patient, diabetic, or even those that are taking HIV medication, or they had heart transplant, kidney transplant, or they are on immunosuppression. Because we know they are the ones to be taken out first, you know. We need to protect them in a way that we can even take them out of Kwisatz Moon and put them somewhere for the next maybe 60 days or 90. Just to protect them. The rest of the people who are already having the virus circulating among themselves will have to pass through the wave to obtain herd immunity. And that increases the immunity actually in the community. So that's my advice. I'm not a decision maker, as you know. But this is the only way. Otherwise, we will test and spend resources and kill the economy. But in the end, we get the same or less things than the other study.
This is the second time Haufiku has been fired by President Gengob. In 2018, the media reported that Haufiku was allegedly fired from his position as the health minister by President Gengob, where he was replaced by the current health minister, Dr. Kalumbi Shangula. Haufiku was then appointed by President Gengob as his special advisor on health matters.